the first decade of this century, the university celebrated the 25th anniversary of the undergraduate symposium, and we're about to have the 33rd anniversary of the undergraduate symposium, which at this year's symposium luncheon, the speech will be named, and in the future will be named, the Dennis Beagen keynote address. Of the 20th century saw Dennis as the acting dean of continuing education, leading the successful campaign for scholars, and bringing to a very successful close the year-long celebration of the university's sesquicentennial.
The little Dennis Beagen in my life, a sesquicentennial on his watch, a capital.
Then novice department head, Dennis helped lead the successful Bill Theater campaign, and actually handpicked the men from the faculty and the administration who would be the first university administrative faculty dragline. Many of you remember some of the lovelies in that line. There was Lady Lavender, and of course, Sister Larry Delaney, and of course, Dame Don Lochnow. The successful close of that campaign led to the opening of this, the Spongberg Theater, and the opening number of the show that was first done in this theater. I'm getting my act together and taking it on the road.
So tomorrow I hit the road, gonna let loose all this heavy load and fly. Music is my one salvation, singing is my celebration, and playing with a rock and roll band is a natural high.
Of course, the 1970s saw championship forensic team become the norm. And as coach and director, Dennis led them to national championship after national championship. And along the way, as they toured the country, he tried to buoy them with song.
Shoot, fly, fly, an apple pen down.
A little something like this.
Shoot, fly, pie, an apple pan down, he makes your thighs rise high.
No. We'll leave that back in the 70s. Let's get back to the decades. It was the 1960s. Matriculated from Brother Rice High School to Eastern Michigan University, where Dr. Gary Evans recruited him for the forensics team.
Puff the magic dragon by the sea, and frolic to the autumn mist in a land called Hanabee.
Well, sort of fast reverse right now to that most consequential of years, 1945. The year that little Denny arrived. But you know, it's probably no coincidence that the hit number of that year really foreshadowed the spirit that the Dennis brings to all of his endeavors and to all of us.
make the positive even. May make the negative latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr.
Sing it when we're done.
To accept, to make the positive even. May make the negative latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. in between.
Yeah,
You have done so much for the university, for the students, the staff, the faculty. You have touched everyone as you have touched me. I hope your retirement is every bit what the two of you deserve. I was hoping you hadn't seen this because I wanted to tell everyone it was that cute picture of you and Gary that sits in the band inserted here, but you deserve this.
Well, Dennis has always started a lot of traditions within our department, some that are harder to continue than others. And one of them is very special gifts like John Charles did for Dennis and Shard. But last Wednesday, not even a week ago, Steve Martin came into my office and said, "Wendy, what are we going to do for Dennis?" I'm thinking, Steve, I'm just out of ideas. I don't know. That was his problem. But he came to me looking for ideas, and I thought, I have no idea. I don't know what to do. I can't figure it out. I guess we needed you there. So we spent the entire day kind of milling ideas around. I called Jane, and Jane emailed me back, and we did a variety of things. And then finally, about 5:30 that evening, Steve, Kathy, and I were sitting down, and we came up with something. And it isn't with a tradition that Dennis has started in this department where you kind of find that different way to recognize people. And it goes back to Steve remembering that he created an on-air sign for, who did you say it was for?
Oh gosh, Bill Swisher.
Bill Swisher.
He did the on-air, remember that? We took that off of the wall in Court TV and we mounted that for him.
Yeah.
And then for Jane, he had to do the cafe sign, Jane's Cafe, because we are known for having treats in the office a lot. So when Jane retired, she got the Jane's Cafe sign. I hope it's up in your house someplace. I never know if it is. Good. So he came up with an idea, and Steve's going to explain it to you because I'm really excited about it. It is cool. I hope you guys think so too. I hope Dennis and Char think so too.
You're
in trouble.
Well, we knew this had to be something special. It couldn't be something like a simple piece of decorative artwork or anything like that, because those of you who know Dennis, it has to be a project. And neither one of you or I could figure anything out. So who's known Dennis long enough to know how his mind works? Jane. So we had to call Jane. And Jane's sitting there going, "Well, of course you guys don't have any ideas. The idea man isn't here." Light bulb. So, by special arrangement with the Martin Miracle Manufacturing Corporation, we have come up with the ultimate gift. A precision instrument that will allow you to bask in the glow due to your fabulous ideas. Precision engineered device which will read your mind. Which you want to compute and give you feedback. And it doubles as emergency lighting in a power outage. But only if you have really good ideas. I present to you. She moved it on. The idea tester. Simply think of an idea. You might let us know what it is. Push the button, and you will get feedback.
Messages that they tended to give back to Dennis and keep coming with an idea.
Quite honestly, Gary referenced it, and Ray referenced it, and Ken referenced my coming to EMU. I told this story before, but it's actually a true story. I thought I was going to go to college in Ohio, John Carroll University. I had hoped I was going to be able to play basketball there, but I found out I wasn't tall enough, fast enough, or good enough. I called the athletic department because a friend of my brother's was going to Eastern Michigan. His name was Ron Davis. He's an alum and now a teacher. I guess a retired teacher. And he said, you ought to look into Eastern Michigan. So I called the athletic department, and at that time the basketball coach was a gentleman named Dick Adams. And I talked to him on the phone. He said, come on up and visit. I met Dick Adams, he's a wonderful man. I went over and applied for admissions, and he'd been enrolled that same day. And then the dorms were full, which is a good problem, Dr. Martin. So I had to find a roommate. It turned out a high school friend was going to Cleary College, Ron Dawes. And we rented a room, 1012 West Cross. And elderly woman lived downstairs, and we lived in a bedroom upstairs for the year. And Dick Adams, although I tried out for the basketball team, I wasn't tall enough, fast enough, or good enough. But he became one of the first mentors that I met at Eastern Michigan. To this day, he's a dear friend. He always greets me, always asks me how I'm doing, and I'm forever indebted to him. But then I met another person in my History 101 class. Some of you may even have had him for class or know of him, in Reinhard Wittke. Mm-hmm. At the end of my first semester, and it wasn't because of Reinhard, Professor Wittke, like a lot of freshmen, I was thinking of transferring. And he said to me, hang in there. Just give it another semester, and I did. That's when I met Gary Evans, Tom Murray, and got involved in forensics and speech activities, and to be honest, it changed my life. I became a graduate teaching assistant. I went to Michigan and worked on a master's at Michigan, thanks to Tom Murray and John Sattler, and I taught at Eastern Michigan as a graduate teaching assistant. Changed my life. I have been very fortunate, very blessed, the mentors along the road. I can't even tell you from Harold Sponberg to Don Drummond to John Sattler to Gary Evans to Tom Murray. I could go on and on and on. And contemporary people who perhaps didn't even know they were mentors to me. There were persons that I looked to, and I said, wow, I'll follow that idea. I'll give you one example. There was a department head in history and philosophy. And I was a new department head, and it was a tough job, particularly as a new department head. And at that time, President Porter had what he called 2550, which we had to recruit 2550 new freshmen. And I know this year we exceeded that number, and FIDEAC students. But I was in a meeting in 219 Gray Herald, and I really walked out of that room, stomping out of the room, because we had to actually call recruits and asked them if they were interested in coming to Eastern. And I heard Ira Wheatley say, And he, again, was terminated by that time about 12 years. I can't do this job. And I thought, well, if he can't do it, it actually gave me some inspiration. And that's the kind of thing that I've been fortunate to have happen for me every step of the way. I can't say enough how much this department means to me, how much the faculty mean to me, the students mean to me, the student office, support staff. I said in the lobby, I miss all the people, but I don't miss the work. I feel that I did what I could do, and I did the best I could, and not always what people wanted, but what I thought was the right thing for the students and the situation. But this afternoon has been wonderful. I thank you all. Especially want to thank my wonderful wife, Charlene, who keeps supporting me through all this. And she's been supporting me for the last 4 months with the health challenge. And because I've told many of you, it's going very, very well, and all the markers are good, and we're really optimistic, and now know we can now travel, and that's what we're going to do. So thank you again.
You know you've made it when your face is on a cake. Partially eaten. TruEMU. Wow. And all the plaques.
And his is right here.
Where's, oh, there's his. Holy cow. Look at that, huh? That is impressive. Yes, he ran for mayor. Hall of Fame. This is very impressive. This is the, what was it, WSDA, I think were the call letters of the EMU TV facility. And here's the studio, still here after all these years. Oh, when I was in school here, I remember. And then right behind that glass was WHUR. Holy cow. The old gate for it. What used to be in this corner was the board right in the corner.
Board? Scully?
Now.
Remember the Scully?
Good God.
That was that little rack with the couple of VCRs in it, and the old Shinfron switcher was...
This room is considerably different than what I remember. Look at this. Holy cow. My God.
One thing has electricity, Art. That's one.
Yeah.
Thank you.